We established in 1995 in Baroda as an architecture and interior designing firm by me, founder architect Hitesh Modi, my partner architect Amit Srivastav, and my wife architect Neha Modi. As a firm, the policy or the philosophy is to not to design mechanically, that is from the program given by the client, and approach with a mechanical process of the architectural designing that we have learned, but more about understanding and connecting with the client and designing different human experiences. We were approached by a mid-aged couple, both doctors by profession, and they bought about 1600 square feet of a plot. The plot was in near airport. We were allowed to construct vertically, but you cannot go beyond 40 feet of height. The brief was a ground floor with two parking space, multi-utility rooms, the upper ground floor with a drawing, dining, kitchen and all, and one guest bedroom, and rest three bedrooms for their two children and doctor couple. The site is located on south facing road, all surrounded with similar 1600 to 2000 square feet of a plot, and a fantastic common plot which is on the south side of it. So this was a site approached from the main road. The containers I saw stacked on each other without any columns and beams. They have the sheer walls, and the entire container itself is a structural element. Similarly, we thought of designing this residence with this shell kind of a structure. So from ground till the upper ground floor level, there's a conventional column and beam. And then we terminated all columns and beam and thought this residence as a three cubes of RCC, one cube in a brick, the upper in a concrete, and the third again in the brick. So all three cubes are as if they are stacked on each other, and they are not just a visual element, but they are structurally been thought as the elevation derived from it. Ground floor was thought as a parking for two cars and a multi-utility room, which he can use it for any social gatherings and all. And the actual residence was started from upper ground floor level. So ground had two entries. One was a car entry for parking of two cars, and the wicket gate which leads to upper ground floor level where the actual home starts. The staircase leading from the road, the main activities like drawing, dining, kitchen were designed as an open plan. The upper ground floor was designed as a common open space with only a guest bedroom. There were no columns or beam in between. Hence, the only peripheral walls were the structural characters, and everything else was the partition walls in between. The intention was to have a maximum size of window towards south, but this fabricated balcony was introduced to shed the southern side of the windows, but yet connecting entire kitchen, dining and drawing room with the common plot. We thought of allowing entire first floor for a doctor couple to have their master bedroom along with the their dressing and attached toilets and all. So we thought of designing his bedroom, the couple's bedroom, overlooking entirely the common plot they have. The southern side of almost 150 square feet we have allocated for a terrace. second floor consists of both children's bedroom. The southwest part was designed as a son's bedroom, a 16-year-old son. The son was more inclined towards the sports. The son's bedroom was being thought as a natural white brick backdrop. The entire palette of white floor, the brick wall, and on the same lines of master bedroom was provided with the hanging balcony in MS to have a south side shadow and maximum connect with the common plot. A staircase connecting terrace, which was thought as an interesting art element instead of a conventional staircase, and a champa tree was planted on the second floor. The southeast part was the daughter's bedroom. The daughter was more inclined towards art and literature. The balcony was proposed to have her a space which connects her with her a cozy space to connect with her art or her literature. Even the artwork was derived with considering her liking towards literature. And this was a fantastic journey of 21 months to transform every species of individual, that's the client, his son, his children, and transforming it into a three-dimensional experience, which I think is a quite satisfying process.